Hi, I'm Dr. Joel Kinneman, President Emeritus of College of the Desert. I'm sitting here at the beautiful new Paloma Resort in Cathedral City with Chad Gardner of Gardner Hospitality Group. He owns and co-owns many of the Valley's premier restaurants in Coachella Valley. Chad, could you share with us some of the restaurants that you...
I have the Paloma Resort where we're sitting at, where I'm a partner in the overall project, and we're going to be opening Soli Sombra, Spanish restaurant. That's my latest project. My first one was Dash and a Handful Catering, and that one was an homage to my mother because she was a chef, and that's how we came up with the name Dash and a Handful. Then my first restaurant was 533 Viet Fusion, a Vietnamese fusion restaurant in Smoke Tree. After that, I opened Roly China Fusion, and I named that one for my husband. His name is Rolando, but we call him Roly, so I want to put his name on the door. Most recently, in February of 2021, but we started the restaurant during the pandemic with Willie Ryan. We opened 1501 Gastropub, Uptown Gastropub on North Palm Canyon next to the Arrive Hotel. And then the latest restaurant was opened last February. It's called Willie's. And that was another partnership with Willie Ryan. And that's in Rancho Mirage.
So Chad, you have all these amazing restaurants and you've been such a successful entrepreneur. You employ over 300 employees throughout the desert. So can you tell me, where did you get your training?
Well, amazingly enough, I went to COD. I got my culinary arts training there. One of my most fond memories was working with Chef Benno. And I know that goes back a few years because he's not with the COD anymore, but he was probably the best thing that ever happened in my life and my career, to be honest.
Well, things are a lot different than they were back then. So can you talk to us about your journey?
Yeah, I've come a long way, and I attribute it all to my culinary training at COD. You know, when I first started there, I was certainly not in the position that I'm in now. I was struggling. Classes start at 7 a.m. and I was literally taking the bus from Palm Springs to COD, and it took me over an hour. So I was on the bus at 5 o'clock in the morning, 5 days a week, to go do the training. It was tough. It was a wonderful experience. And it's put me in the position that I'm in today.
I'm happy that you made that journey and you've been so successful. So.
Yeah, well, you know, like I said, our classes started at 7 a.m. And so if I was to take a 6 a.m. bus, I would be late every day for class. So I literally was up, you know, 4 o'clock in the morning taking the 5 a.m. bus so that I could be there on time every day. It was a struggle. And then, you know, in addition to that, working to get, you know, to support myself through college, things were, and supporting a partner at the time. We have some definite struggles. I'll tell you about a particular time that I look back on and is very humbling and makes me appreciate where I am today. I was banking with a local bank and I had miscalculated my checking account balance and I thought, oh my gosh, they're gonna pay the check but they're gonna charge me a $35 fee and that's my budget for the week for groceries because that's where it was back then. And I thought, okay, well, I'll just go put a dollar in the ATM to cover because I was like 50 cents short. I looked at the console of my car and I didn't even have a dollar in dollar bill, so I had to take change and go inside the bank and drop a couple quarters in as a deposit. And let me tell you how humbling that is, that things are so tight financially. And I look back on that as my main driver, you know, that I continued in school. It was worth every, you know, sacrifice having to work a part-time job to finish my culinary training there.
Around 2016, we passed a bond measure, and yes, over $300 million was dedicated to a Palm Springs campus that was going to have culinary, hospitality management, a learning hotel, accelerator space, a restaurant, and it was all going to be integrated.
Yes.
And really give students a different kind of experience. And unfortunately, that's been put on hold. And it's not moving forward at this time. And it doesn't look like it's going to. What impact do you think that has to future students? Or how would that have benefited you and your role?
in each one of my kitchens, I want either a student, an intern, or a recent graduate from culinary in my kitchen. And having a campus here in Palm Springs would just be an amazing asset to my companies, as well as I think would be a great benefit to the students, because, you know, having students working in actual kitchens, it keeps my team sharp. I feel like it's my way of giving back, because COD gave me so much. The elevation to the culinary department and what it would do to this area in Palm Springs that's growing so rapidly, I think not having that here I think it would be a tragedy.
I mean, as we were listening to business owners in the development stages, we were hearing that there's such a need. And we were also hearing that with the Palm Springs brand, we could elevate what we were providing educationally, and also be maybe a national training site in some ways.
Well, the advantage to having, you know, a working hotel, a working restaurant in your culinary program is that, you know, so many students, they get book training and they get hands-on training in an educational kitchen. But to actually get the training where you're actually taking care of guests in real time, and you're working in a working restaurant and a working hotel, it's a game changer. It prepares students so much more. They're leaps and bounds ahead of a student that comes out with just educational training. I would be greatly disappointed if we didn't complete the campus. I think it's vital to the culinary program at COD. It'll benefit so many students.
Well, and it was promised to you.
We voted for it.
Yes.
Yeah, and paid for it.
Yes.
You know, so we've just got to get people to honor their word for what we agreed to.
Well, Chad, I want to thank you very much for taking the time today. You know, Chad is an example of work hard and make your dreams come true. Chad, I just want to say thank you again today, and I really, really appreciate your endorsement for me on this campaign.
My pleasure. My pleasure. You're welcome.
It's an honor.
Thank you.
My name is Joel Kinneman. I'm running for Area 4 of the Board of Trustees, and I approve this message.